We only don't have a whole lot of time. I would ask you just ask a question. If you want to make a speech, you can come up and get in our face afterwards. There's a mic there at the podium. Bobby and then Matthew, if you want to respond very quickly, and then we'll take the questions.
Yeah, I think you've hit on this point, a very, very important point, which is what do you do with this giant pipe of news and things that look like news or purport to be news coming at you? And I think the answer to all of this is, the answer to all problems is education. About 15 years ago, some friends of mine, former colleagues at Time Magazine, went to the State University of New York and launched a program called News Literacy, which is not for journalism students. It was done out of the journalism school, but not for journalism students. It was specifically for people of every other discipline to come to the journalism school and learn how to make sense of all these different news sources. And it's a terrific program, and it was the first of its kind. I hope more and more American universities pick it up. But more importantly, I hope schools begin to pick up things like that, because you have to start teaching kids from a very early age how to distinguish between news, analysis, comment, and complete sort of humor.
Right.
Far too many people get their news from the Daily News, the Daily Show, which is very funny, but it is not news. And how to make a distinction? I think there needs to be modules in schools. Now I met somebody here afternoon.
Just stop you there and go to Matthew, because I really want to get to the questions.
Yeah, Bobby's saying it better.
Oh, okay. All right.
Then I want to point out somebody if he's in the room. Bob Van Oosterhout, are you here, Bob? Yeah,
yes,
Bob's right back there. Now Bob is actually doing this. Bob is working to try and create templates by which people can understand the difference between news and fake news and sort of hate speech and so on. And so there are people who are already working towards this, and I encourage people to reach out to Bob when you can. He's the guy standing back there. Bob, would you put your hands up again? That's Bob.
Thank you. Yes, your question.
Yes, hi. My